But here's the truth. You can experience high levels of success in your work and your life.
Even if you don't exercise,
if you got no life balance, eat all the wrong foods.
If you smoke, if you drink too much,
even if you don't get enough sleep, even if you're high stress, you can still experience high levels of success in your life. And some of you are thinking,
oh, thank God.
Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. I got this, right?
I want to talk about the things that we can do physically, mentally, emotionally, cognitively to take care of the physical machinery and brilliant mind in it, because this is where all of your excellence comes from.
But here's the question I have for you. If you're already knocking it out of the park and you're not taking care of your health, imagine what will be possible once you do.
I believe that it's not necessary to trade stress for success or to sacrifice employee well-being for higher profits. In fact, I know it. To me, health is the ultimate competitive edge we each hold that, when nurtured, will drive results, enhance focus and purpose at work, and bring higher levels of success to everything we do. My husband calls me a professional freaking ray of sunshine, and I'll own that. For over 20 years, I've directed all my education and experience into keynotes and workshops that inspire real change and drive sustainable results. And I love what I do. My keynotes? Well, my keynotes are a fascinating blend of science and common sense that get my audiences thinking, dreaming, and most importantly, pushing outside their comfort zone. They're interactive, educational, and engaging. And I'm told I'm a lot of fun. Which is great, because research suggests that laughter helps people learn better and retain more after the event. As thinking, feeling, analyzing human beings, we tend to complicate the situation until the formula becomes, oh, more like the dream times gaining skill plus knowledge times hard work, that equals success, yes? We're gonna divide that by daily effort minus distractions, plus persistence times passion, multiplied by focus minus sleep, which equals no energy to the power of fast food, not exercising, huh? Plus patience to the power of caffeine and anxiety meds, which we're gonna multiply that by a few days spent in self-doubt, which equals stalling, right? Add in an injection of confidence from watching someone else fall on their face. Add in a little bit of guilt for feeling that way, and that equals a reminder to quit comparing your journey to everyone else's. Heck yes. That equals a renewed belief that you can. Oh! All the while, my friends, we're gonna multiply it by hope that we can, and a deep down belief that it's possible. And that is the formula for success to the power of what? The front door. We need to look where we're going. We need to have our eyes very clearly on the goal, off in the distance, as far as it may be. And when we keep our eyes raised to that thing that we want, you can do the power pose if you want. I'm not entirely sure it works, but sometimes it just feels fun to feel stupid. Right? If we're looking at the prize at the end, we are moving forward even if we're standing still. Do you hear that? We are moving forward even if we're standing still, because if I look down at the gaps, I'm more likely to retreat in fear. Stand in your power, look to where you're going, and if you need those days to catch your breath so you can take the next step forward, catch your breath, but don't retreat. You know, when audience members take action after my keynote, that's the magic, and that's why I do what I do. Something I've noticed throughout my career is that the world is full of people who have no idea how extraordinary they are. Way back in the day, as an enthusiastic personal trainer, all I knew was to try and help those people one at a time. It didn't feel like enough, and it was the start of all that I do today. Now, I'm a bit older and hopefully a lot wiser, and I have this fabulous opportunity to inspire change in numbers, to coach leaders and speak to audiences across North America about how to sidestep stress, skyrocket success, health, and happiness, and ignite high performance. As a motivational speaker, what I know for sure is it's not about inspiration. That's the easy bit, and my sessions bring it. It's really about perspiration. You've got to do the freaking work. I strive to get my audiences learning and laughing, yes, but what really lights me up is when I see them get to that place where they believe they can, where they trust in themselves enough to take the next step towards whatever they're chasing. Whether you want to crush on the job, lead with confidence, or live a happier, more balanced life, better than ever starts with that.